30 years ago today, Love Me Do, the Beatles' first single, was released. It reached number 17 in the charts and was the first big step that took the Fab Four to worldwide fame. To celebrate the anniversary, the British Council has organised a Beatles exhibition, which they'll be taking to 57 countries and the rest of Britain over the next 2 years. And the definitive book about the Beatles was also launched today. What is it about the Beatles that fascinates you so?
Everything, really. I mean, the bottom line is, of course, the music, but they were so much more. In a sense, what we're here today to celebrate is the 30th anniversary of the birth of a culture, if you like. I mean, popular culture. And the music and the fashion and everything that they created in the 60s was very important, I think.
Both the book and the exhibition record the history of the four Liverpudlians from the time they first got together in 1957. Opinions are divided, by the way, about why they christened themselves the Beatles.
They were great admirers of Buddy Holly in the crickets, and if an insect name was good enough for Buddy Holly, an insect name was good enough for them. Then there was a spelling of beat music, B-E-A-T, and that influenced the spelling of their name. Thirdly, they were great admirers of the 1954 Marlon Brando film called The Wild Ones, in which the motorcycle gang was called The Beatles. You pays your money and you takes your choice.
However they got their name, all their recordings were made at the Abbey Road Studios, and Ken Townsend, then an engineer here, worked on all of them.
My memories are quite clear on the very first day. It was the 6th of June 1962, when we had an artist test booked in the studio from 6 till 8. And George Martin was producing. And four lads walked into that door with long hair, quite unusual for the time, and sat down and recorded these songs.
What did you think of them? Did you like them?
Absolutely, yes. I think they're wonderful.
Why?
I think it was so different. And when you know people as well and get them work with them, of course, you probably like them more than other people who don't know them. So I think some of their songs were fantastic. No, I just think they were very, very good. And their music really stands the test of time.
Abbey Road Studios are still a shrine to the millions of Beatles fans worldwide, and because of them, 30 years on, Love Me Do and all the other 210 Beatles songs are still available in record shops throughout the world. Love Me Do. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.